a police service member, and I would love for that to happen.
Pride politics, more on the relationship between the parade and police next.
Closed captioning provided in part by Kevin.
Pride is in full swing and there's lots to celebrate, but it's also time for reflection for members of the LGBTQ plus communities who've suffered unimaginable losses that have renewed quite concerns about the relationship with Gibraltar police.
When you are just, you know, just coming out of what seems to be 10 murders in your community or involving your community in less than 12 months, then it really raises some vital questions for us about not only how it is we sort of live safely and comfortably, but also the notion that, as you said, with our institutional partners, those people that exist to protect us, that we have to have conversations with them about what it means to step that up, how it is that homophobia and discrimination affects the way in which cases are investigated.
Police community relations, where is that now?
You know, it may seem a little incongruous, but I'm actually incredibly proud of where we are with our relationship with the police. We, as a result of what we've just talked about, ask that they not participate until we are sort of able to reflect on what's happened to us and reflect on how we want to move forward. And they've been nothing but willing partners in that request.
For the second year in a row, uniformed Toronto police officers will be on the sidelines since they've been once again asked not to march in the parade.
We are more than willing to hear the criticism and, you know what, take ownership in what we didn't do the best at. The reality is, this isn't the only conversation we've been having. It isn't just about pride. It's, like I mentioned, it's multi-layered, from the homicide investigation to the missing persons, right? And we've been having those ongoing conversations, and I think a lot of people think that the only reason we're doing that was to get back into pride, and I can assure you that that wasn't our priority. Our priority is building this relationship back with the community, however that may look, and the conversation started prior to pride, and it will continue after pride.
Do you think that the relationship will get to a point where police officers are once again marching in pride?
I hope for that. I mean, I'm an out, proud Toronto Police Service member, and I would love for that to happen, but we have work to do before that happens. So for me to say that it's going to happen next year, I can't. We do have work to do, and we need to start listening to the community better.
Sunny conditions expected for tomorrow, anywhere from 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. And that means a Pride Parade forecast. We could expect some showers, also the risk of thunderstorms. I'm going to break it down for you. This is what we're expecting. Overnight tonight, we fall to about 17 degrees. Our daytime high for tomorrow will be around 21. The average high for this time of year is around 25. So you get it. We're below seasonal. And on top of that, you need the umbrella for tomorrow. Summer radar showing us this system, this cell out towards the south, out towards Sarnia, is starting. This could potentially reach our area. And so that means tomorrow afternoon, we're going to see some soggy conditions, heavy at times, about 5 to 10 millimeters of rainfall. But the rain does start up at around 9 a.m., continues on and off throughout the afternoon. By the evening period, around 5 p.m., it starts to clear up, and after that, clouds start to clear. But some cells could be heavy at times throughout the day tomorrow, bringing up some rainfall or significant rainfall for some areas, like Sarnia. Now, Sarnia is under right now a special weather statement. They can see up to 40 millimeters of rainfall here in the city of Toronto across the GTA. It's going to be more to 5 to 10 millimeters of rainfall. Our future cast showing us this rain starts up for areas north of the city, Newmarket, areas like Woodbridge, Georgina, around 6:30 a.m. Here in the city of Toronto, around 9 a.m. It gets heavy throughout the afternoon, but clears up throughout the 5 p.m. hour. After that, clouds start to clear. Throughout the overnight, it starts to clear, setting up for a very nice Monday. Monday, sunny skies for the work week. So things are looking good heading into the work week forecast. That's until midweek, where we start to tap into those thunderstorms again. 17 degrees our daytime high right now. We're sitting at Brampton, also sitting at 17 degrees. The humid X, you can see, around 21, 20 up towards Barrie. Our Pride Parade forecast, we start off the morning at 18. Those soggy conditions I was talking about, from 9 right throughout the 5 p.m. hour. Our daytime high for tomorrow, around 21. And this is what we're expecting for the next 7 days. We start to warm up slightly, that risk of thunderstorms for Wednesday, and by next weekend, the sunshine makes a return, but also the hot, humid temperatures make a return. So by Thursday, Friday, it will feel closer to 40. That's a look at your 7-day forecast.
Some Toronto residents.